Although Microsoft has decided to continue supporting Windows 10, most users will eventually be forced to upgrade to Windows 11. But what if your computer does not meet the technical requirements set by Microsoft? What if you want to upgrade to Windows 11 but don't want to lose important data and applications you currently have? Flyby 11 is a free and open source program that allows you to upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11 even if your computer does not meet the technical requirements set by Microsoft, while preserving all the settings, applications, and data you currently have on your operating system. To demonstrate how this works in practice, I installed several programs on Windows 10 and created two text documents on the desktop. To perform the transition from Windows 10 to Windows 11, we will need two things. First, we need ISO file for Windows 11, which we will download from the official Microsoft website. The link will be in the video description. When you visit the website, find a section that says Download Windows 11 disk image. Click on the drop-down menu below this text and select the option Windows 11. After that, click the Confirm button to confirm your choice. Next, you will have the option to choose the language you want. I will select English, United States, but you can choose the language that suits you. Click the Confirm button to confirm your choice, and when the page loads, click the 64-bit download button, after which the download of Windows 11 ISO file will begin. In addition to Windows 11 ISO file, we will also need the program through which we will perform the upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11. Flyby 11 is an open source program that we will download from the GitHub page, where you can also view the program's code. When you visit the site, and you will find the link in the video description, look for the section that says Releases, and click on the link below this text that contains the program's name and the current version. Once you do that, a new page will load, and at the bottom you will find a section titled Assets. Click on the first link in this section to download the program itself. After the download is complete, open the folder where the downloaded file is located, which is usually the Downloads folder. As you can see, in my case, in Downloads folder, I have the Flyby 11 program we just downloaded and the Windows 11 ISO file we downloaded earlier. Since Flyby 11 comes in zip format, right-click on the file, then select Extract All option and choose the location where you want to save the content of the file. If you leave the Show Extracted Files When Complete option checked, the newly created folder will automatically open. In the newly opened folder, find the icon named Flyby 11 and double-click on it to run the program. When you do this, you will likely receive a warning from Microsoft Defender that the program is unrecognized, in other words, unknown publisher. Click Run to give permission for the program to start. At the beginning, the program will analyze your computer to determine its technical capabilities, in other words, whether it is possible to install Windows 11 on your machine. When discussing technical requirements, it is essential to clearly distinguish between real technical requirements and those set by Microsoft. The conditions set by Microsoft, which we could also call artificial conditions, are essentially designed to compel you to buy a new computer if you want to continue using Windows. Examples of these requirements include TPM, Trusted Platform Module, version 2.0, Secure Boot, and similar features. These requirements can be bypassed, and the program does just that. It circumvents the artificial requirements imposed by Microsoft. On the other hand, we have real technical requirements such as the SSE 4.2 instruction set, without which the Windows 11 kernel for version 24H2 will not be able to boot. These technical requirements cannot be bypassed. As you can see, the program will initially check whether your computer meets the real technical requirements and will provide you with a success assessment of the process. If, like in my case, the upgrade probability is very high, click the Start Upgrade Now button to continue the process. In the newly opened window, on the right side, you will see an explanation of how you can download the Windows 11 ISO file. When you click on the drop-down menu in this section, you will see three ways to download the ISO file. The first option, Microsoft site, is exactly what we did. In other words, we downloaded the file from the official Microsoft site. All we need to do now is drag and drop the file into the area that says drag and drop the Windows 11 ISO. Once we do that, you will see the message mounting ISO, which essentially means that the program is unpacking the given file. When this process is complete, PowerShell will launch. Click Yes to grant permission for the program to run. After that, you will receive a notification. Windows 11 installation can now proceed. Please follow the instructions in the setup window. Click OK to confirm. When the installation process starts, you will see Install Windows Server. Don't let this confuse you. Despite the word server, the program will install the version of Windows you are currently using. For example, if you are using Windows 10 Pro, Windows 11 Pro Edition will be installed. If you are using Windows 10 Home, Windows 11 Home Edition will be installed, and so on. If we click on Change How Setup Downloads Updates in this section, we will have the option to choose whether we want Windows and drivers updates to be done during the installation or not. I will select the second option, not right now, because I want to perform the update after installing Windows 11. But you can, of course, choose the option that suits you. When we click the next button, we will need to agree to the terms of use by clicking the Accept button, after which we will reach a section where we can choose what data we want to keep. The first option, which is selected by default, Keep Files, Settings and Apps, allows you to save all your data, all settings made in Windows 10, all applications you have installed, and all data will be preserved and transferred to Windows 11. The second option, Keep Personal Files Only, means that only personal data, in other words, the data you have in folders like documents, images, desktop and similar, will be saved, while all applications that do not come with Windows and all settings will be deleted. The third option, Nothing, will erase everything. If you choose this option, a clean installation of Windows 11 will be performed on your computer. I will leave the first option selected, which will allow us to keep everything. When we click the next button, we will get a summary of the settings we have made. As you can see, the program has detected which version of Windows 10 I am using and has determined which version of Windows 11 will be installed based on that. If everything is as you want it to be, click the Install button, after which the installation process will begin. During the installation process, the computer will restart once or multiple times, which is normal. You will also likely have the opportunity to set security settings. It is recommended to turn off all options in this section. But of course, depending on what you want, you can adjust the security settings according to your needs. When the installation process is complete, as you can see, we have Windows 11 along with all the programs and data we had on Windows 10. Now we will check if the programs are working and if the text documents we saved on the desktop are readable. As you can see, everything is working just fine. If we open File Explorer and navigate to the Downloads folder, we can confirm that both the program FlyBy11 and the Windows ISO file we used are saved as well. Feel free to leave any questions, suggestions, or ideas for future video content in the comments. Thanks to everyone who took the time to watch this video. I hope you find it useful or at least informative.